Morning. Morning. Welcome to worship here at Horizon this morning. I am happy that each of you are here. If you're a guest with us today, if you wouldn't mind, fill out a visitor card. Let us know that you were here. Any way that we might be able to serve you. Thank all of you for being here. May we worship the Lord together this morning. If you will, join with me in looking at a few announcements this morning. Coming up on Wednesday, May 25th, we will be having a church-wide volleyball tournament and cookout. Supper will begin at 5:30, the volleyball tournament to follow. The church is providing hot dogs, hamburgers, buns, and drinks. All of you are asked to come out. Bring side dishes and desserts with you. There's a sign-up sheet available in the Sunday school hallway. But please make plans to join us for this time of fun and fellowship as we kick off summer. Also, graduate recognition Sunday will be May 22nd. If you have a graduate you would like to recognize, please call or email the church office by 3 tomorrow so we can make sure to get those names in there. You will also find a correction from me in the bulletin. I boo-booed a little part of our service last week, but you will find an explanation and a correction in the bulletin there. And see, that was the thing about the baby dedication service. I goof every week, but only I know what I'm going to say, so you don't know. But last week, other people knew, and I goofed it. So the correction's in there, and again, my apologies to that family for my mistake. But they happen. But I do hope y'all have had a good week, and I'm thankful you are here, and I'm looking forward to a great morning of worship.
God the Revealer. God reveals beauty in our lives if we will just open our eyes to see it. God reveals truth if we open our minds to accept it. God reveals love if we open our hearts to receive it. God reveals wonders if we open our arms to embrace it. May we each day open our eyes, open our minds, open our hearts, and open our arms that we may receive a message from God.
Thank you.
children's moment this morning. Has there ever been something you really wanted to do, but you didn't know how? So you had to wait till you learned, or you had to wait till you were older to do it?
Shoot a shotgun.
Drive a car. You driving yet?
No.
No, not yet.
Driving go-karts.
Go-karts. Things like all those things, or learning to swim, or ride a bike without training wheels, play a sport, tie your shoes. I'm still trying to learn how to do that. But to get to be able to do those things as we grow older and we can do more things and things that we really want to do, we have to work at it, don't we? We have to learn. And it takes lots and lots of practice on some things to learn how to do it well. And it's hard. It can be frustrating when there's something you really want to do, but you don't know how, or you're not very good at it. But it takes time and it takes steps, and we have to work. And you know something else we have to have? We usually have to have help, don't we, to learn new things and to do new things. But when we get frustrated or we don't know how to do something, does that mean we should just quit and stop trying to learn?
No.
No. That's called determination. And in our Bible story today, Jesus is getting ready to go back to heaven. And he tells his disciples he has a mission for them. He wants them to tell everyone about him and what he's done. You know what? Jesus has been with them and Jesus has taught them everything they know. But he's leaving. How do you think they felt? Probably sad. I imagine they were probably a little scared too about how they were going to be able to do this thing without Jesus. But Jesus tells them that they've got to have determination to not give up. And Jesus also promises them help. Jesus promises them what we call the Holy Spirit, which means Jesus is always going to be present with them and help them, and that they don't have to do it alone. But what they have to do is have determination and never give up. And that's Jesus' mission for us too, that we live the way he wants us to, that we will tell others about him even when it's hard. And we can do it because we have help. Jesus is with us. Let's pray. Dear Jesus, you have given us our mission. May each of us have the determination to accept our mission, to live for you, and tell others about your love. Amen. Thank you.
Please stand as you're able for hymn number 570.
Thank you.
Our next hymn is number 436.
Let us pray. Lord, thank you every day for the blessings you give us. Help us to use these blessings and our talents to serve you better. Be with those in need due to health or other reasons. Use these tithes and offerings for your service. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Our scripture reading for this morning comes from the Gospel of Luke, the 24th chapter, verses 44 through 53. Then he said to them, "These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses, the prophets, and the Psalms must be fulfilled." Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures, and he said to them, "Thus it is written that the Messiah is to suffer and to rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance and forgiveness of sins is to be proclaimed in his name to all nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things. And see, I am sending upon you what my Father promised. So stay here in the city until you have been clothed with power from on high." Then he led them out as far as Bethany, and lifting up his hands, he blessed them. While he was blessing them, he withdrew from them and was carried up into heaven. And they worshiped him and returned to Jerusalem with great joy. And they were continually in the temple, blessing God. Determination. It's a character trait we often think of when we think of people who have had to endure tough circumstances, but yet they somehow still manage to pull through. We may think of our own stories and our own times in our life when we had to have determination. Those moments when we had to put our shoulder to the wheel and keep on pushing to make it through a tough time in our life. Or we may think of a loved one or a friend who, in the face of what seemed like insurmountable circumstances, was able to push through something that we ourselves thought we couldn't have done that. It's also a popular theme for books and movies as well. A good story about determination and grit usually almost always makes for a good movie. And one movie I've always particularly enjoyed is The Shawshank Redemption. And Andy, a character in the movie, is a successful banker. And he's sent to Shawshank Prison for a murder of his wife and her secret lover that he did not commit. At first, he finds himself very isolated and lonely. But through his journey, he finds himself figuring out that there's something deep inside us that people can't touch or get to or take away from us. And that's determination. The determination to hold on to hope no matter the circumstances. And in prison, Andy becomes friends with the prison entrepreneur, Red. And Andy shows us why it's crucial to have dreams. His spirit and determination show us not only what it takes to survive, but to even be able to thrive in the harshest of circumstances. His determination that things that have happened in his life didn't have to dictate his future, but instead they could influence it to be better. I've often found inspiration in stories like these. But not to spoil the movie, but Andy, if you haven't seen it, but Andy uses his skills to develop a library and to educate fellow prisoners and prisoner guards about finances, and he's able to rebuild a life for himself within those walls. And I found that to be inspiring because life is challenging. And to get through it, we have to sustain a certain amount of that determination to survive. My life has most certainly had its ups and downs. It's certainly not always been easy. And I imagine that most of you can relate to that. But when we think of determination, is it merely just what I've described it as thus far, a character trait, or is there more to it? Is determination a part of our faith? I think so. I think it's a significant and important dimension of our faith. Without determination, the will to wait and to follow the Lord, then I think the other dimensions of our faith and our life quickly crumble, especially under pressure. But with determination, we have the ability, even when it's hard or even impossible, to see God at work in our lives and to hang on. Knowing that something better has been promised and is on the way. Some of you here this morning may have been there. You may have had those moments in your life when you simply said, God, I don't know where you're at or what you were doing, but I've done all I can do. Now I've just got to wait on you. It's a scary place to be honest. Waiting on God. But with determination, we can also feel the excitement and the anticipation that God is going to show up and God is going to do something. And I imagine this range of emotions is what Jesus' first disciples felt as Jesus shared those words that we read with them. As Jesus prepared to ascend back to heaven, the disciples were left to carry on. It's very hard for me to believe that there wasn't a great sense of anxiety and fear among them. Even if they hit it well, as they imagined, what do we do now? But Jesus told them to wait, that help was on the way. And with that news, it's equally as hard not to imagine that the disciples were not jubilant about their future. The text tells us that they went back excited and praised God as this news that power from on high was on its way. I don't think life in 2016 is really all that different than the life these first disciples found themselves in, especially in church life. If one pays attention to statistics, it's pretty easy to figure out that churches are scared. There's a sense of anxiety. Numbers are down. People are walking away from the church. You can't read any Christian news source without hearing this. And there's a lot of doom and gloom, and the world's changed, and the church hasn't changed. And that's why people are leaving the church. What do we do now? How are we ever going to be the church again in 2016 the way it was in the 60s and the 70s or even the 80s? How are we going to deal with this? But I think if we pay attention to the words of Jesus here, we find great hope and encouragement and a call to determination. A determination to stay here and not walk away or throw in the towel, but to wait and to see what God is going to deliver. A determination to hang on until God's plan is revealed. And that's not a passive waiting. I think too often we are tempted when we hear, wait upon the Lord. We think of it as this passive waiting of sitting around and doing nothing and saying, okay, God, it's your turn. But rather, as Jesus calls us to wait on His movement and His power, He's calling us to go on about the business of our lives and the life of the church, even as we wait for God's direction. To live with determination. But some might say that that's easier said than done. But the way that we do it is listed right here in Jesus' words. If we don't let it slip by us. If we look at the words that Jesus gave His disciples, He drew upon the past to encourage them to be able to endure the present. And He used the present to encourage them to get excited about the future. In the 21st century, there is this mindset or this drive that anything from the past is bad. If it's old, get rid of it. But Jesus reminds us that that's not always the case. Even as the disciples were preparing to embrace the new age of the kingdom of God that had come in Jesus Christ, Jesus points them backwards. He tells them to look at the prophets, the Psalms, and the law. He reminds them that the law established the foundation for how God's people were to live. The prophets were there to tell them when they had missed the mark. And the Psalms tell the story of how God's people relate to God. And in all those things, Jesus reminds them and us, He was present. So then tradition and memories of God's work in the past is what delivers to us the good news that God is still at work today. God has not just shown up on the scene, nor is God far in the future, but God was and God is. And determination requires us to ask those who walked the road before us to show us where the road turns, where the steep drop-offs are, where we might find fresh water along our journey. Jesus then tells us the past is not to be lived in, but rather is the feeding tube for the present. That as we draw from the past, it fuels us to live today. And Jesus moves from that past into the reality of the present that His disciples faced. The disciples knew Jesus was real because they had seen Him. To have the determination that we need to get through the present, we too have to learn how to see Jesus. And I think we do that by asking questions like, where is grace being experienced? Where is forgiveness being offered and accepted? Where are the sick being healed? Where are broken hearts being bound? Where is the stranger being welcomed? Where is faith being practiced? Determination calls us to see the best in every circumstance. To see hope where no one else sees it. God provides grace, the means by which God is available to us every day. In the present, we must be determined to live life in such a way that we actively seek to experience the grace of God. Be it through prayer, worship, reading the scripture, holy conversation about hard questions, or putting our faith into action through serving. If we are to be determined to wait on the Lord into the future, we must actively seek God's presence today. Jesus says, wait. But while you wait, do not forget your mission. And Jesus is clear that if we have the determination to hold on and fulfill our calling in the here and now, there is indeed a future. His instruction is, wait until the power comes from on high. To wait on the future, we have to be determined to make it to the future. The disciples had to believe Jesus when He said that there was a future. God keeps God's promises. If God says power from on high is coming to us, then power from on high is coming to us. The resurrection was only the beginning. God's empowerment of God's people would be an ongoing thing and is still an ongoing thing. And when we learn to live with that sort of determination, that we not only think God will do something, but that we expect God to do something, that's when we experience the excitement of walking with God. Something fun that we like to do with Cade is give him surprises. If we get him a new toy or we're going somewhere fun or whatnot, we won't tell him what it is ahead of time. We just tell him, Cade, you've got a surprise coming, but if you want it, you've got to behave. It's amazing how that helps. Should have promised him one last week. But not only inspiring him to behave better, it does something else. It builds excitement, and it builds anticipation. And even if it's a dollar toy that we happen to see at the checkout at the Dollar Tree or wherever, if you tell him you've got a surprise, when that moment finally gets there and he gets it, it's like you gave him the best thing in the world, because he's built up the anticipation and the excitement, and that moment has finally come. The surprise is his. And I can't help but think that if we viewed God's promise of power and blessing as a child views a surprise, then how excited might we get about what God is up to? What surprise might God have in store for us? When we get to the future, God will already be there. And what a surprise it will be. So what does that anticipation, that determination look like? My favorite quote from Shawshank is, Andy and Red are talking about a fellow prisoner who was released but could not handle life on the outside. So they were quickly failing in their life outside the walls. And Red says, these walls are funny. First you hate them, then you get used to them. Enough time passes, you get so you depend on them. That's the opposite of determination. Getting used to and dependent upon walls. But they often come up in life. Be they obstacles, discouragement, or the like. But walls pop up in life that slow us down, lower our expectations. And we hate them too. It may be something in our past, something in our present that we're enduring, but we feel that feeling of constraint. We feel that wall holding us down, pushing us down, and we hate that feeling. And at first, we're determined to get past it. But if we're not careful, before long, our determination gets a little less. We get used to the restraints, the status quo. We begin to accept things that are less than ideal as normal. We begin to think less and less about the future and care less and less about our present. And before long, we're dependent on those walls, that we've lost our determination. And we don't know how to function outside of the self-imposed boundaries that we put in our life. We allow ourselves to be defined by what we can't do, or what we won't do, or what we're unable to do. Determination is breaking those walls down. It is realizing that with the help of Almighty God, that we have the ability to learn from our past, to embrace the rich tradition from which we come, while also knowing and trusting that we can evolve and adapt to the present and believing that we can thrive in the future. So this morning, if you find yourself lacking determination, find yourself bound within those walls, then I encourage you to make up your mind today that you are a beloved child of God. And believe that you can be all that God has called you to be. And church, again, there's a lot of talk about what the church is supposed to look like today. But the key thing I believe is that the church be rooted in this determination that we not be constrained by walls, be they physical or otherwise. That we not be limited by our own thoughts or opinions. But that we truly actively wait upon the Lord. That we seek out to be who we are called to be. Determination calls us to be a community of refuge where trustworthy relationships develop, prayer sustained, friendships flourish, visions arise, and hope is born and reborn again. This day and age calls for us to be determined to be a community of resistance where the reign of God and the ways of Jesus Christ are held up as an alternate vision to the reality of selfishness and scandal and greed that the world tells us is the way to live. These days call us to be determined to be communities of resilience, where tenacity and perseverance trump shallow answers, painless solutions, and casual commitments. But rather to be determined to be stewards of that gift of faith which our forebears gave us, to be the presence of Christ in our world today, and to remind the world that Jesus Christ is here and still at work. But to also wait in and believe that God's plan for the church is alive and well, and that power from on high is still on its way. Be determined to be all that God calls us to be. Amen.
Six 41, stanzas 1 and 4.
Thank you.
once again, God reveals to us beauty if we will just open our eyes to see it. God reveals to us truth if we open our minds and accept it. God also reveals to us love if we open our hearts to receive it. God also reveals to us wonders if we open our arms to embrace it. May we each day live with open eyes, open hearts, open minds, and open arms, always open to receive a message from God.
Of my heart.